Okay, supposedly we're live. The YouTube site is not behaving. Like, it doesn't actually show me as live. Which is weird. I also need to stop this extension for now. Because it's throwing fits. Some things while we do this. Let's speed up the browser a little. Okay. Let's see, we recommend use a bitrate of 4500. What am I doing? I'm probably just doing default. Stop and restart. And we should be live again any second now. Is live. Okay, looks like I am live, so there's the link. Stream is live, and here's the URL. that out. Okay. If anyone's actually there, I'll let me know how the audio is, if it's okay or not. Mic's a little ways away, but it's pretty sensitive, so it might actually be too hot, not hot enough. It's hard to tell. Throw it in the chat. Okay. Right, we've got the troubleshooting out of the way. Everything else looks good. Okay. So that's okay. Let's pop out the chat so I can see it there. So that's better. Okay. So, and I think we're good to go. So, hopefully my audio is okay, and hopefully this looks okay. So, now that we've got that, I will start recording as well, just in case I need to re-upload this cleaner. So, and then I will start. Okay, OBS is recording. So, we have several folders to go through tonight. We have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 5 folders of pictures to go through. Most of them don't have much in them. They're just random stuff from the last week, so. We'll start with this, the 24th. So here's Darktable, typically. So I sort all my pictures by date. So this is obviously that day. So first, I will apply my defaults, which is basically lens correction, default tone curve, etc. You know, nothing overly fancy. And once we do that, we'll flip over to the darkroom and start looking at the pictures. And I'm trying to remember where. Oh, that's right. I took these over by the dentist office the other day because I had an appointment, and there was some neat sun effect and such there, so this could actually be challenging. So let's see what we can do with it. I think if we pull the exposure, I'm not sure I even put the filters on for this, so let's pull the exposure up a little. We want to be able to see everything. That's a good balance. So we've got the sun, a little bit of lens flare, not surprising when you're shooting into the sun. Also, let me know how that color actually looks. Because for some reason my OBS screen and on the YouTube preview, that sky looks orange, brownish orange. So let me know if it actually looks that way to somebody if you see this. Let me just look at the settings real quick. But, nothing looks odd in the settings, so I'm not sure what the deal is there. Color format, maybe. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not sure if it's just the preview of the capture or what, so let me know. Let me know if the sky is actually blue or some weird color. So let's see here. Maybe. Can you pull that do anything? Okay, so there's the defaults for local. Does it do anything good if we... Not really. Okay. Yeah, see, that's blurry. So turning local on definitely helps. Pulling the highlights down doesn't really do much for this. So we will do that. Contrast, I usually like to tweak a bit. Whoop. What did I just do? Huh. I have never actually done that before. I usually do like to pull the contrast a bit. Especially with clouds, I think that looks good. Saturation doesn't really do a whole lot on this one. Let me pull it up a bit. I like to really pull those clouds. Let's play with the brightness. Let's see. Yeah, that's bright enough to see easily. Looks pretty good. I think that sun looks kind of cool there, although I would like to tweak it. Let's see if we can... Let's see what messed with the tone curve does. Interesting view. It's not realistic, but it's definitely interesting. Okay, let's put it back to flat. Okay. We do want to... Yeah, let's see, that actually makes it a little better. Pull the middle a little. I like that. Now, do we want to play with a mask and see if we can pull some definition out of the sun? I think it's usually a parametric. By the way, I am not good with masks. I always have to completely tweak them. There's an imp. That's right. Where is the... that's right. Exclusive and inverted. What we want is that overexposed spot on the sun. Did that do that? Or did I do that backwards? I did that backwards. So, straight exclusive? I can never remember how these masks work. I thought exclusive and inverted is what I normally did. So right now we're masking only the sun, which isn't what we want. So we want to mask everything but the sun, or pretty close. See if that does anything. I think that's doing what I want, so I'll put that back to about there. Duplicate instance. Inclusive mask. I think that's pretty good though, because that did pull out the sun a little. Give us a little more. Yeah, that's just way too much. I That gives us some pretty clear definition. Brightness just a tad. Got some rays, we can see it. We've got some good definition of the clouds. Okay, let's mark that. A little different view. The sun, if I remember right, is actually right there behind those clouds. So we'll give it a little bit of extra exposure. Get that local contrast. Contrast a bit. Saturation doesn't do a whole lot on this. I need to pull that back down a little. So I'm losing that spot right there. And that looks a little better. One from this set. Pull up our exposure until it actually. This needs a bit more. That was a pretty dark image. Might have had the ND filter on these, I'm not sure. Local contrast is good for clouds. I probably usually like it. See if we've got good definition. Not too bad. I pulled up the light down a bit. Loses the cloud. That's not bad. We're still missing something though. That's not bad. And those highlights down. Doesn't really make much difference on this. Let's see if. Oh, that's way too much. To our default. And this is interesting, but no. That's not bad. It's kind of a hard one because that's so bright and that's so dark. I think I like it. Although we don't have much of the blue sky on there. Can we pull that? Where's the blue? Well, I guess there's not much of it. Not too interesting things. Just reset that. Twin curve isn't doing much on that one. That's interesting, I like that. So that just loses it. It's too much. About there, I think. Okay. That's about as good as we're gonna get on that one. So, let's look over these. Need a bright day, so I don't need to denoise them. We will bottom left watermark them. That seems to be a good location for these. I actually set up all four corners because sometimes it just depends on the image where it'll be least intrusive, I guess you would say. We'll tag these as nature and sun because they all the sun. Now this is actually the first time I've tagged anything in here, so it'll be interesting to play with that. And then we will export them. So you see, I actually export based on EXIF information and image. So I get nice numbered images in the correct folder. Okay, so it takes care of that set. I have to pop this chat back in. It's not exactly busy. Storage. Okay. So we processed 8.4. Next up we have 8.29 was the actual next folder with anything in it. Well, that we want to look at. The others were just me shooting random stuff in the house for whatever reason, my old camera kit and whatnot. So defaults. Oh yeah, some of you can obviously tell when the lens correction goes on. More clouds. I like clouds. As you can probably tell. White balance I generally don't mess with unless it's just totally off. Oh yeah, that looks better. contrast, saturation, which I know saturation doesn't do a whole lot with clouds, but sometimes it helps a little. Now, ooh, that's way too much. Give some good definition, which just pulls it out too much. I'm gonna pull those trees up a little bit. You can kind of see the greens and purples. The leaves. It's not bad. Blue looks blue. We got some good definition on the clouds. I like it. Okay, next. And those lovely close shots at the sky. I think, yeah, you can see the sun there. So we don't want to go too far, because we're going to be messing with the curve of it. There we go. Apply contrast, default looks good. Too much on this one. Saturation brings that blue sky out. You can probably tell I usually go for about 35 on both for most stuff, this kind of stuff I do. It's because I think it gives good color and definition. Yeah, that's not gonna work. We want to pull the bright down, but we want to pull too much there. This one's going to be able to do a lower curve. That's not bad. And if we want to brighten it just a little. Up there? It's pretty clear on the clouds. I don't know, we might need to pull the exposure up a little more. Yeah, now we can actually see the blue sky. Little vignetting. I probably had the polarizer and the ND filter on, I believe, when I was doing this set. Still like to bring it up a little more. Man, that just loses the definition thing. It's even flat, that loses the definition, so we really gotta pull that back. A good middle ground. There, that's good. You can see that real clear, and then you can see the sun shining in there. I like it. This was a great cloudy day. Okay, so, shooting down late. No, we might lose, we might just lose the clouds on this one. Let's see what we can do with the curve. See there. I'm going to pull that all up. Ooh, there we go. Now we're getting. We want to get this so we can this anymore. So that's way too much. Think so. I kind of like it. Got the bright red of the wall, cream, and then those. Yeah, that's cool. Boot. Whoa. Okay, we can't do. We'll blow that out. There we go. That's not bad. Get our little clothes on. Contrast, saturation. Okay, tones. It's gonna be another challenging one. Okay, we want. Definitely pull that up. But we need to pull the brights down. That's weird. There, that's clean. That's pretty clean. It's not bad. Pull it just a little. And pull the brightness a little without blowing out the clouds. Sharp greens. Yeah, there we go. And of course the classic, how shot. So I need to pull the exposure down. And I think we're just way too overexposed in the clouds. I'm not sure as much I can do about that. It just kind of is what it is. Okay. That helps a little. It's not bad. Still blown out on those clouds, but let's play with the mask. So I should find the actual mask area. so that's pulling exposure on everything but the mask. So we want inclusive. Study up on those, so I think that's about as good as we're gonna get it. There we go, that's a little better. We don't have a massive blowout spot. So this we can actually pull up a little. In those clouds. And then pull back. I don't mind some of the bright, but I want more definition. There we go. That's not bad. Almost the same shot. Exposure up. Close. Duration looks pretty good. Next. Let's pull that up a bit. Because we do have that, we don't want to lose that. Might be too much for this one. See if we can pull it out. That just loses the cloud definition on the other. Okay. There we go. Not too much. I want some of that, I just don't want all of it. That's not too bad. Okay, 2-star images. I like how that one came out. The bottom left. Is nature. Not certain which ones have the sun, so I won't tag that. Export. Okay, so that's 829. Next up is 9-2. Hey, Rose Cries, more clouds. It's been cloudy lately, can you tell? Out of curiosity. I thought there was a setting for a camera, but it's not. Okay. Yeah, this will get tricky. Don't think we want to do much. I'm gonna leave that at zero. I think most of our fiddling is going to be in the tone curve. Let's put these to my defaults just to see. I might have to tweak that. Well, that's giving me an interesting look there. There we go, with that blue sky. Cool, I like it. I think the sun's right there. It's probably another one that's just gonna blow out if we do much. So we can pull it up a little. Yeah, there we go. No, these must have been over at the commons, because I could see the light fixture. Export. Alrighty. 9-4. I love these. These I'm ignoring. I was just taken a couple of shots in my old lens kit. So that's already actually already been exported, which reminds me I need to rename that director. Yesterday morning when I was getting ready to go to work, so it was basically a quick grab and shoot, so we'll see what we can do. Yeah, so we definitely don't want full exposure up on that. Down doesn't do much either. So we'll just leave it default. Interesting look for you. That's like almost black and white.
Like yellow.
Okay, we're gonna leave those just nothing for the moment. There's a fair bit of noise in there too. So let's pull these way down. If we can at least get an interesting picture out of it. I don't want to go too far. Interesting. Can we pull on anything else? Let's see, that's a total rose, is it? All the way down. Just totally pulled up right down. See, I'd like to get back some of that blue sky. That's interesting, all right.
Well, that's,
saturation does not, but that contrast actually. Actually, once it's. I kind of like it. It's weird, but I like it.
Can the whole thing.
No, yeah, see, that just totally blows it out. Yeah, so we need to keep our exposure nothing.
Can we brighten the whole thing up there?
It's weird. It's really weird. But I kind of like it. I'm going to go with it. I mean, I was not expecting these to be decent shots with how bright that was. I'm not using a filter, so. I mean, I basically threw the camera on 200 ISO and shot. See, that is not round. Yeah, these are 1/5 of a second. Let's try this one. Just throw it on our defaults and see what happens. See what we can do with it. So, if we pull them out. I think we can do enough with this one to make it anywhere near.
That almost makes.
Yeah, I mean, look at that. It's just a straight out, massively overexposed. Okay. So we're just gonna stick with the one shot. Because, I mean, it's weird, but at least it's interesting. Let's go. Let's go bottom right. Denoise it. And export. Okay. And today. These might be a little better. And I forgot to tag those. Like that. And let's go back. Unless I'll forget. It's the moon. And of course, it's nature. Okay. Now we can go today. Defaults. Now these, I actually had on the polarizer as well as the ND64. So these should be pretty dark but clean. So let's see what we can do. Yeah, and this I just liked because you had the clouds and then just this strip of blue right through it. Looked really cool. Excuse me. I'm not sure on the contrast on that. Just pulling it up, well, there's just a lot of the cloud definition. Maybe there. That's not bad. More trees. Oh, yeah, that helps. It's too much. Trying to do is get a good look without losing too much of the cloud detail. It's not bad. I want good colors on the plants. There we go. I like it. See what happens. See what our tone curve can do, but we might have to back those off. So brighten it up. Pull down the oversaturated clouds. Yep. That nice blue sky. My preview, this all looks like completely brown. This pole looks blue. It's like I'm seeing almost inverted colors. Yeah, if you look here. Yeah, I'm seeing reverse colors. This is actually blue. But it's showing, yep, red. This is cyan showing yellow. White's white. This is yellow showing blue. This is red showing blue. This is like a cyan, showing cyan on my stream preview. That is bizarre. Okay, so now that I've tweaked that, can we pull the exposure up on that? Is that gonna mess up our definition much? Yeah, that's actually pretty good. That's a cool one. The sun right there. So I'm gonna have to watch this video back and see if it actually streamed and recorded with the color palette flipped. So I'll have to check the stream and check the OBS recording. And if so, I'm gonna have to do some testing because that's really weird. Looking at my... See, this actually looks the same. This is green. This is purple. Huh, this one actually looks near correct. Now we'll see what happens when we start. Ooh, that's way too much. Let's pull that up to about 1. Got our local cone. Yeah, definitely pulls up. Okay. I'll throw these are the defaults and see how that happens. By defaults, I mean 0.35, because that's what I just broke. I like it. It's pretty cool. Interesting view. I just made everything purple. Just like that. You know, it's so dark. Extreme, I can't really pull color out of those trees. I'm gonna black and white it. Where is that? I don't actually know how to do that here. Monochrome. Oh, it's part of tone curve? Oh. Where? See, because all the color is really just a spot of blue there in the sky. Because you can barely see the color in the trees. So if we just flat out monochrome it, you can still tell the sun is right there. But it actually cleans it up. This. So brighten it up a little. Just get a good look. No, it just doesn't look good. Kind of like that. Yeah. We got the sun right there behind the clouds.
just, I like it. Monochrome. Cool.
Okay, what do we got here? Look at those models.
Did I favorite that?
Yeah, I did. Cool.
See the blue, good definition on the clouds.
Looks decent. Exposure up a little more now that we've tweaked that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't look good. It's not bad. Can we pull some contrast now?
Good definition of cloud, you got the blue sky. I see that's blowing out the color there. Turn that down too. There, that looks about right.
That's not bad.
That's for kicks.
Yeah, see that one? Because that one, the key point is that shot of blue coming through the clouds. We start losing the clouds.
Locals on. Okay, looks pretty good.
Let's put these at our norms.
Clouds still look pretty good. Look at that blue sky.
Sort of blew the colors all out. last one. What can we do with you? First, let's actually get some exposure in there. Okay, that's still pretty clear. Contrast view, that looks nice. Saturation. Yeah, our contrast just on this just blows those clouds way out. We might be able to pull it up after we mess with the tone curve. There's not much we need to do here. If we pull okay, so we were on 0. That's not bad. That's, I like that. Let's see, and then we start losing it after that. So it's like that's our sweet spot for this. Export. Okay, now I just need to get them all uploaded to a server, into the gallery, make up some journals, and of course throw a few more onto Instagram. So thank you for joining me. If you watched this, I hope you enjoyed it. And maybe I'll do it again sometime. And let me know how my audio was. And I will be checking out the color thing to see if it's just my previews or if it actually recorded and streamed in that weird, mostly reversed color scheme. So. And that will do it for me for tonight. Goodbye.